nothing to do with the actual sport itself. Now, when watching from home, you might think that all aggression is the exact same. However, it's not. It's much different. Now, there's something called anger violence, and that is when there's a motivational state and a negativistic state going on in the brain. It's a very serious form of aggression because it's hard to control and most times leads to very serious injuries. Now, the next form of violence is thrill violence. And that is when a player is looking for something to make himself more excited. Maybe he's bored. He has a motivational state going on in the brain as well. That's quite different from both the anger and thrill violence is play violence. It's much less serious. Play violence is just a part of the game, and it is not very serious. And that's all the forms of violence. And sports alone can be a very addicting thing. The money, the fans, the glamour, the fame, the cheers. But who knows that that violence in sports could be just as addicting? It's a very slippery slope in sports, and many athletes have become known for violence and only violence. There are many things and many steps that it takes to become addicted to violence in sports. You know, violence in sports is a serious problem, but who knew that fans engaging in violence while watching professional sports could be such a problem? You know, who knew that sitting in an overpriced seat in a cold arena could lead me to getting into a fight? But the big thing is, and the main thing is, that the reason these people are getting into fights is because it is a creative way, and it's not an acceptable way, but it's an excuse to let their anger about something else out. You know, they use the excuse of a bad call by an umpire, by a referee, and they're able to get their aggression about something else out because of the sport. And another excuse is because they have a tie to one certain team, something bad happens to the team, they are, you know, upset and they get angry, and so they engage in these fights. And it occurred between Todd Bertuzzi of the Vancouver Canucks and Steve Moore of the Colorado Avalanche. Todd Bertuzzi came from behind, sucker punched Steve Moore in the face. The two fell to the ice, Bertuzzi on top of Moore. And Moore lay unconscious as Bertuzzi wailed on him, punch after punch. The end result of this serious incident, Steve Moore had a broken neck, serious injuries, and to date he has never played another game in the NHL. Todd Bertuzzi was charged with assault. He was suspended for the remainder of the season, and he continues to be involved in civil lawsuits with Steve Moore.
Pump it.
thank you for watching my video. I'm Zach.